Hey everyone, in this tutorial, I'll show you a simple way of using DMX to control the speed of a stepper motor with Touch Designer and an Arduino. Let's go over some of the hardware that I'll be using. This Entek DMX USB Pro will be used to send the DMX signal from my computer. It's connected to this Arduino Uno with a DF Robot DMX shield. Since this will be used as a DMX receiver, I have the second jumper set to slave. The Arduino is connected to this TB6600 microstep driver. The pulse negative is connected to pin 5, and the direction negative is connected to pin 6 on the Arduino. All the positive lines are tied together, which connects to the 5-volt pin on the Arduino. The VCC and ground are connected to a 12-volt power supply, which is currently turned off. These four wires go to the stepper motor, which has a piece of electrical tape to help visualize the direction when it's on. I have this driver set to 4 microsteps by placing switch 1 in the on position and switch 2 and 3 in the off position. For this stepper motor's specifications, I set the current to 0.5 amps by placing switches 4, 5, and 6 in the on position. Now keep in mind that anytime I want to program this Arduino, I need to first disable the DMX shield by placing this first jumper in the position mark that has the EN with the bar over it. Now I'll plug the USB in and we can start programming this Arduino. Let's move over to the Arduino IDE to start building the controller software. I will include two libraries that are required to make this work correctly. If you don't have these two libraries already installed, you can easily go over to the Library Manager and search for these. Next, I'm going to define the two pins that I connected to the stepper motor controller. I'm going to create a variable that tells me what DMX channel to listen on. For now, I'll just set it to DMX channel 1. I'll make a variable called DMX speed, which will hold the information from DMX channel 1. I'll also create a variable that sets the maximum speed of the stepper motor controller. And now I have to declare one stepper motor. I use the number 1 in this case because this stepper motor has a pulse and a direction pin. Now let's go over to the setup section. Here, I will initialize the DMX receiver. I'll also set the maximum number of channels to 512. And then I'll use the SpeedMax variable to set the maximum speed of the stepper motor. Now let's go to the loop section. Basically what I want to do is I want to look at the DMX data, and if it's less than 5 seconds old, I will store that information into the DMX speed variable. Finally, I'll take that DMX variable and I'll use it to set the speed of the stepper motor. The input DMX signal is only from 0 to 255, so we need to scale that to match the maximum speed that we set previously. Finally, we can tell the stepper motor to run. Now let's save it. If you haven't already, go to Tools, make sure your board is set to Arduino Uno, And then your port is set to whatever USB port your Arduino Uno is connected to. Let's compile it first to see if there's any issues. There is no problem, so let's go ahead and program it. Now let's hop over to Touch Designer and make a new project. Let's start by making a base. Let's call the base Stepper Controller. Let's right-click it and go to Customize Component. Let's make a page called Control. In the Control page, I'll create a parameter and call it Speed. For speed, I'll change the range from 0 to 255, which is defined by the DMX protocol. Now I'll make another page and call it Settings. In the Settings page, I'll make a parameter and call it DMX Address. For this one, I'll make the default 1, range min 1, and range max 512. Let's go inside the Stepper Controller base. Let's make a parameter. Then I'll make a select. I'll select the DMX address, and then I'll make a null. Let's make another select. I'll attach the parameter to the second select, and this time I'll select speed. Then I'll attach a rename. In the to section, change it to expression and type as follows. Now if I right click and go to Open Parent Parameters, you can see now when I go to the Settings page and change the DMX address, the channel number will also change with it. But for now, let's keep it at channel 1. Let's make an out. Now let's go back to the main project. Here, add a constant. I will define all 512 channels of the DMX universe, but leave it at 0. Now let's make a replace. I'll add the constant to the first input and the stepper controller to the second input. Now let's add a shuffle. Change the method to sequence all samples. Now let's add a rename. Let's rename this to DMX data. Now attach that to a DMX out. Change the format to packet per channel. Now let's save our project. Now I'll turn on the power supply to my stepper motor controller. So if I click my stepper controller here in Touch Designer, and I go to the control page, if I start to increase the speed, you'll start to see the motor start turning too. Now the problem right now is I can only go one direction. So let's modify our code so that we can make the motor spin both directions. Let's come back to the Arduino code. I'll make a new integer and call it DMX direction. And then I'll make one more integer and call that stepper direction. Since we're using channel 1 to control the speed of the motor, we can use channel 2 to control the direction. So when DMX direction is less than 127, it will go one direction, and then if it is above 127, it will go the other direction. Here where I set the speed, we can take the speed max and multiply it by stepper direction. Since I want to reprogram the Arduino, I need to first disable the DMX shield again. Now hit upload. Now let's come back to Touch Designer, and let's modify our stepper controller. Let's right-click the stepper controller and go to Customize Component. Under the Control page, I'll make a new parameter and call it Direction. Let's change the type to Toggle. Now go inside the stepper controller base. Make another select. Connect the parameter to the select. This time, let's select direction. Add a math. Under the range, change it from 0 to 1 to 0 to 255. Let's take this rename and copy it. But let's reconnect it now so that the math is connected to this rename. Right here at the end, let's add a plus 1. It'll be channel 2 for the direction and channel 1 for the speed. Let's insert a merge. Let's connect the second rename to the merge. Okay, now I'll put the jumper pin back to enable. And then I'll turn on the power supply for the stepper motor controller. Now I'm able to increase the speed of the controller. And I can also change the direction. The final project files with comments are available on my Patreon, where you can download and use for yourself, and also have access to other projects and tutorials that I will continue to share online. So if you enjoy these kind of tutorials from me and wish to see more, Patreon is the best way to support my work, and please like this video and subscribe to my channel. Thanks!